going to discuss a lot of things about free energy generator. For some time now, we have been dealing on how you can build a free energy generator. And many have started working on free energy generator, and some have been sending a sample of their work they have done. And I'm very happy because this is the best way to learn. The only best way to learn is for you to design while you are still learning, and that is what I appreciate most of you of what you're doing. So first of all, before I continue the production, I'm going to go to the comments of what many of my subscribers sent to me, and I want to review a few comments which I know is very important for this new year for you to have a knowledge on. And we're going to discuss and on each of the comments using a practical examples. For instance, let's take from this Mr. Jones Andrew. Which he says something very important in his own comment. He gives to me, he sent to me, he asked a very important question, which I want to read now. He said, which type of alternator electric motor good for fuel generator? Which type of alternator and electric motor that is good for fuel generator? As a first question. And you also went ahead and asked another question here again. You said, please tell us the real sense of fuel and a generator. Some say before it will we will need to modify alternator. Is it true that I should talk about the essence of this, where they will modify the alternator before the energy can generate, before the generator will generate current? Let me go to the last question, the last comment. He said, could you please add a page with all the specification, including width and diameter of the pole, size of the bed, flyweight system? Let me start from first question. This is the first question, number one. Which type of alternator electric motor good for the generator? This is very important because today's production is going to be based on this. Which type of alternator and electric motor is good? There is no specific alternator you can use for generator, for generating of the free energy generator. Every alternator that is kept on is important. What is necessary is that what kind of capacity you're going to use to produce. For instance, if I want to produce this 10 kVA, I put here now, there's a particular alternator which we're going to use on that. And that is where we are going to talk about. Like for instance, now this is alternator I'm going to use, and this is 10 kVA. Now, if you want to produce this kind of capacity of generator, or that will give you 10 kVA, it's necessary for you to use this AC alternator. So look at take what the AC alternator, because it's AC. But in the case where you are going to do a maybe 3.5 or 2.5 kVA generator, you can go for DC. For instance, this is a different classification. Now this is AC, you have 15 kilowatts, and from 10 to 15 kilowatts generator system, you can produce 15 kilowatts, because sometimes this one you have 10, so that can have 15, depends on the capacity. So you can use this alternator, so this electric motor, to produce 10 to 15 capacity of your energy. Then you can, when you have like this is 3 kVA, you can use 12 volt DC. As you can use 12 volt electric motor which run with batteries, you can carry the 3 kilowatts of a generator. So the capacity of the generator determine the capacity of the electric motor. Andrew, I don't know if you have gotten what I said. If you want to produce from something from 10 kV and above, you are advisable to use at least electric motor that has up to 1.5 kV. And sometimes you have this electric motor over. So from something from 5 kV above, I will advise you for you to go for electric motor. Why do you have to go to electric motor, AC electric motor? Because The consumption rate every 8, some AC electric motor carry up to 1 kilowatt, some carry more than 1.5 kilowatts. So when you subtract the consumption rate of the electric motor from the generator, you should be able to have electric voltage left. But in this case, the first, for instance, now, this is a generator. The generator has only 3 kilowatts. Now, this electric motor is 1.5. Now, you now attach this electric motor to this generator. Now, before you subtract the 1.5 kilowatts from the 3.5, then from 3 kilowatts, you only have 1.5 kilowatts left. And now, you need to have a reserve current, which means sometimes the coil may not give you complete 3 kilowatts in production rate. So you keep, let me say, 0.5 kilowatt aside. Then what you left now is just 1 kilowatt. So what will 1 kilowatt do in your house? What kind of electronics can you plug in 1 kilowatt? So you now see that the electric motor might have taken over half of your generating power. So that is why in this case you are always advised to use the DC motor. In this case, the batteries is being used to power this one. So to reduce, because the DC, the DC motor does not require too much voltage to run. So but it still runs this generator well, because what matters most is the RPM. So if you are going to if you have a generator with this low kilowatts, you are advisable to use a DC motor so that the voltage consumption from the generator will not be too high. That is the essence for that. But in a case where you have not to this kind of 10 kilowatts to 15 or 20, 30, 40, 50, as the case may be, you are advised to go into something bigger. Because let me tell you now, if I subtract, let me assume that is 15 kilowatts. If I subtract 1.5 kilowatts from 15 kilowatts, what is left is about 13.5 kilowatts. And 13.5 kilowatts is enough to power your AC, fridge, and other electrical appliances. So you now see that even if you run this system, just like what you have seen here now, even if you run the system now with this one, you still have a good power reserve, because that tells me that you are using 12 kilowatts left for your production and then leave 1 kilowatt as a reserve power. You still run perfectly well. So that is why you are advisable to use the DC motor for this system that has for a generator that has a high consumption rate, and then use DC motor for the generator that has a low consumption rate. This is very important for a system. So you can answer that your question here has been answered, because this is where some of you have a confusion now. So which type of alternator electric motor good for a generator? So now, in terms of the production, the types as you may use, the type of the generator, I will ask you to don't follow the type. Because sometimes you follow the type, you may be misled, because some company may do something different from what you want. And what you should follow is the coil. Follow the coil, the type of coil they are using in running and producing the generator or the electric motor. The coils, most of the time, I advise people to go to full copper coil. If the coil is copper, fuel copper, not aluminium, you are going to have the best you want in your production. But if you go for something that is not a copper, the tendency that you may not have what you want is there. So I advise people to go for copper. And if you buy copper coil, you are going to have a good production. So if you are asking for a type of generator or electric motor you should go for, I would advise you to go for a good coil that is a copper coil and not aluminium coil. If you go for a full copper coil, you're going to have a good production irrespective of the company. Because I can't say you can go to HP company, go to AP company or AC company. I can't say so because if I say so, what if you go there and what they use in producing the machine is not what is actually is good enough for, like maybe it's not a good copper coil, so you may have an issue. So better go for the coil system. The specification should be good. Ask for better coil, the better copper for that. So I think this is what, and so the next question I'm going to do, I'm going to focus on this question again, because the question, because I want to answer the question on practical form, because I just answer like this, some of you may not even understand what I'm saying, but if I produce what I've showed you practical like this, I explain something like this but practical to you, you should be able to have the sense, the wisdom of what exactly I mean, and then you have a good understanding, because that's the essence of this channel, for teach you and also dedicate you practically on how you can design your fringe generator and other fringe serum system. So that is where I'm talking. So now let's take a look at this practical system and look how this is being configured and